Our other top story of the early afternoon, we're learning more details about a violent attack in a Stockton courtroom. KCRA3's Rich Ibarra, he's live right now in Stockton with the latest from the San Joaquin County Courthouse, now back open after that deadly incident yesterday. Rich.
That's right. The courtroom opened this morning, at 8 o'clock this morning. People going back inside. Things were normal, pretty much the same. David Paradiso was on trial for murder, and yesterday he was on the witness stand when suddenly attacked Judge Cinda Fox, going after her with a knife-like instrument, going after her neck, the same way he killed his girlfriend. Judge Cinda Fox was taken to St. Joseph's Hospital, treated and released. Her wounds, mainly superficial. Today, her courtroom remains sealed. Detectives still inside gathering evidence. And this morning, jurors returned to collect their belongings.
And that he stood up, and then Pacheco, his lawyer, was trying to get him to sit down. And when I turned around, I saw him on top of the judge getting ready to either stab the judge or kill the judge or whatever. And then that's when I saw Officer Bradley come around.
Also back was Aaron Paradiso, who said his brother told his family he had a weapon, which they in turn reported to the sheriff's department.
I believe it was a scissor type weapon, something formed from some type of hair cutting device. That's what we told the county jail a week or two prior to this.
Paradiso's defense attorney can't understand why Paradiso attacked the judge.
This judge was just extremely kind and nice to him. There is no reason for him to have attacked her because she was on, she was making the rulings, and they were even keeled. They were favorable to us, favorable to the DA. I had no qualms, and she was just kind to the guy. There was absolutely no reason for him to have done what he did except his mental.
Now, I spoke to one judge who spoke to Judge Fox this morning. He said Judge Fox is recovering and doing fine. She seemed in good spirits. Now, later tonight on this evening's news, we'll talk to the Sheriff's Department about the security that was in place and also what was the weapon that Paradiso used. Reporting live in Stockton, Rich Ibarra, KCRA 3 reports.
And this morning, Paradiso's defense attorney joined us live in the KCRA 3 HD newsroom. He described what it was like in the courtroom as his client attacked the judge.
I reacted. I didn't know I did, but I once the Paradiso jumped on the judge and began to stab her in the neck, I moved from the counsel table up to the judge's table, and she was laying on her back looking up towards the ceiling, and Paradiso was working on her right side of her neck with some sort of a sharp instrument and with a stabbing motion. And I found myself right up there at the judge's bench to assist her. And then a police officer came from my left, reached over my shoulder area, and put a gun against Paradiso's chest and fired.
Pacheco says that he thinks Paradiso smuggled his weapon into the courtroom by concealing it in a leg brace that he was wearing.